Hi, Alex from LaserMic again. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to service the focus lens on the FiberCut 2D. Here's what you'll need to perform this service. A can of clean dry air, a new pair of powder-free gloves, a 3mm and 4mm hex wrench, a single bulb LED flashlight, a small flathead screwdriver, your new focus lens, a lens insertion tool, and a roll of 2-inch tape. Before we begin, it's important to remember the FiberCut 2D has sensitive internal optical components. Whether you work on your head at your bench or directly on your machine, you need to remove all contaminants from its surface before performing any maintenance procedure. You also need a clean work area while servicing your FiberCut 2D. Now let's get started. In order to get to our focus lens, we have to take off our tip retainer assembly and our lower manifold block. So we'll start with the tip retainer assembly, our TRA. That simply unthreads from the head there. Make sure you have your free hand ready to catch that. We'll just place that to the side. And that'll give us access to our LMB, which is held on by three screws on the bottom here. See these kind of recessed holes, 1, 2, and then 3 there. So we'll grab our 4mm hex wrench, get those in there. These screws are also held in by the adapter boss there. So they won't fall out once you start to take them off. The lower manifold block itself does have a couple dowel pins holding it on as well, but always have your free hand on the part there so it doesn't fall off. There is an electrical connection that's made there as well, so we don't want any damage to that. And the third one here, you can see I've got some movement in my lower manifold block now once that third one's cracked free. And everything should pull apart. So real quick, we're gonna tape off our lower manifold block. See this O-ring kind of pops loose sometimes, so just be mindful if it's on this surface here, or that it when it, if you don't see it on that surface there. So we'll get our 2-inch tape, cover up our lower cover glass there on both ends. Just using a painter's tape, it doesn't leave any residue. Get some good oversized pieces on there so you don't forget about the tape when you're putting anything back together. And that gives us access to our focus lens here. So you can see we're kind of recessed all the way up in there. If you're, rather than trying to fish the tool all the way in there, we can actually manually drive that lens down. You can see this small little screw here. Just take that off with a flathead screwdriver. It's only a couple threads, so be ready to grab that before it falls and disappears. And then we can grab a 3mm hex wrench and we can drive this lens all the way down. You can see it's starting to move there. It's just a little bit easier to access that focus lens with it fully extended down there. And you'll see that's as far as it'll go. Ball screw won't turn anymore. Now, when you put it back in, you can put it back in that position too. So once you're plugged into your machine, it'll reset the focus lens itself. So we can get the screw back on there. We won't have to move that focus lens again. So you can see now on the focus lens, you may be able to see there's two little slots on the holder there. So we can use our lens insertion tool, kind of line those slots up with one another and crack that free. It shouldn't be too difficult to crack free. This shouldn't be in there excessively tight. Then we'll pull this out. So again, real quick, we're now exposing the rest of the head there. So we're gonna wanna tape that surface off as well. Lay our focus lens down on its side. We don't want any contamination get on the top or bottom there. So keep it in that horizontal position. Tape off this orifice here. Place that to the side. So you've got your focus lens. You're either just checking it for contamination or you're going to replace it. So while we're here, let's say we're checking it for contamination. If you see a large burn spot or damage, we can get rid of that one. We'll grab our new focus lens here. Again, before we install it, you always want to check it with your single bulb LED flashlight on both ends. If you see any dust or debris on there, Give it a little blow off with some clean dry air. Check it again. If everything looks good, we can get it ready to reinstall. So what I always do is I kind of place it on my lens insertion tool to begin with. Always keep it in this horizontal position. Remove our tape. And then we'll bring it in. And if you're doing this on your machine, same kind of process. Keep this horizontal all the way till you get to the machine and then bring it up into the head like so. But with it in this horizontal position, we can keep everything on the same plane. This should thread back on nice and smooth. If it feels like you're forcing it, you are probably threading it in wrong. So take your time, back it out, restart your process there. So you get to the point to where you stop turning lightly and then kind of just give it one more little bit of force. Again, we don't want to over tighten this, cause any damage to the threads, make it harder to take out the next time around. So just nice and easy when you're putting that back in. And then one rule of thumb I like to do is just kind of lightly turn it counterclockwise, like you're going to take it out, but not actually. Make sure that there is no movement in the opposite direction. So that's how you should know that you're tight enough to keep it in place there. So again, we don't need to adjust its position. We can keep it right there. We can grab our lower manifold block. I like to put the old focus lens in a safe spot for now. Mark that, make sure you know it's bad. If it is bad, place that to the side. Get our lower manifold block. So you can see if you do tape that occasionally, the O-ring will stick to that tape. So just be mindful of that. Get that back into position, sitting in its groove properly. While we're here, make sure these orange O-rings are also in place. Not that everything should be seated properly. Before we connect it, make sure your electrical connection looks great. No damaged pins or anything like that. And we can, again, horizontal position. We don't want anything falling on that lower cover glass there. We can use our dowel pins to help line this up. Nice and easy. Grab our 4mm hex wrench. Get one of them started to where it feels like, again, where you can stop lightly turning it almost to a full stop. Want to make sure all three are threading in properly. And then once you're there, get the final quarter turn or so to make sure everything's nice and tight. So you should look nice and flush all the way around. There shouldn't be any gaps. If you feel like your screws are tight and you do see a gap or you're not seated flush all the way around, could be an O-ring pinched or you're just iron crooked. So just make sure that everything looks nice and flush and how it should there. Grab our tip retainer assembly. So the thing to pay attention to here, turn the head for you guys. You see there's the gold pogos here and also the gold pins on the tip retainer assembly. Those are what line up with each other. We want to try to line those up before we really secure this down. We don't want to do what we call the search and destroy method, which can really tear up the coating on these pins here, which can cause some height sensing issues or grounding issues, which obviously we do not want. So really just pay attention, make sure that we're lining up these gold pins with these gold pogos to begin with. So you can see with that, I'm kind of in place. I can't really turn it in either direction. TRA, the tip retainer assembly, is where it should be. I should be able to thread that nut on there nice and smooth. And since we did have the lower manifold block off, really quick, we're just going to check our lower cover glass, make sure that no contamination got on it. We'll get our single bulb LED flashlight, give it one quick look, clean dry air. Everything looks good. Place that back in the head. Make sure your door latches properly, seals properly. And with that, you're all set.
Be sure to review your instruction manual for complete operating and maintenance information. Thanks for watching.